and Boris Epstein, a Republican strategist who is backing Trump. Good to see you both. Boris, I'll start with you. Let's talk Trump. He's doing so well in the Florida polls right now that Marco Rubio's camp is telling Ohio supporters to vote Kasich so that the governor can defeat Trump. Do you think that strategy is going to work?
Well, no, especially because Governor Kasich came out and said he's not going to do the same thing in Florida for Marco Rubio. This is the exact type of maneuvering that voters in both the Republican and Democrat Party are tired of. We need to listen to the voters, and the voters are overwhelmingly saying they want Donald Trump in state after state. You look at Michigan, Alabama, New Hampshire, Massachusetts, state after state, and then you look at Florida polling. So, you know, that is not a good maneuver, one. And two, Marco Rubio does not control his voters. He could suggest anything he wants, but he's a failing candidate who's likely going to be out of this race tomorrow. So I don't know how much weight that holds at all.
Yeah, people do say it is do or die for Marco Rubio. But Kari, let's talk about Hillary Clinton. Does she worry, let's say Trump ends up being the Republican nominee, that he has such enthusiastic support, you could call it, or does she welcome the matchup if it is in fact Trump?
No, I think she definitely welcomes the matchup. I think most Democrats are clamoring and chomping at the bit to get a hold of Donald Trump under just the broad notion that the country is going to reject xenophobia and bigotry. But even more importantly, when you look at the sub-levels, when you look at the demographics of a race of Hillary Clinton versus Donald Trump, you see something that's relatively astounding. The gender gap, the Gallup poll gender gap between men and women showed that Barack Obama had one of the largest gaps in the history of presidential politics over Mitt Romney. We expect that that gap will expand when it's Donald Trump versus Hillary Clinton. I think Hillary Clinton will trounce Donald Trump in support from women voters. So we look forward to Donald Trump. I can honestly say that Democrats, independents, and a lot of Republicans look forward to beating back Donald Trump and saving our country.
Kari, are you concerned at all about today maybe a possible upset like we saw in Michigan? Are you concerned about people turning out to vote? We heard that lower voter turnout on the Democratic side. It's been a problem for Hillary.
Well, let me just speak to the voter turnout briefly. The voter turnout is somewhat of a red herring. I mean, if we go back to 2000, it's a very similar campaign. You look at a race that was after a two-term Democratic presidential president in Bill Clinton, and you had Republicans outperform Democrats in the primary season by a tune of 3 million voters. Now Republicans are still outperforming Democrats, but if we look back at 2000, we remember who won the popular vote. The person who won the popular vote in that matter was Al Gore. Although he didn't become president, he didn't win the popular vote. But Hillary Clinton's not worried today. The reason being is because she's going to have an extremely, extremely strong showing today in Florida, one in North Carolina, and she's going to win the delegate count and expand her lead to an even larger amount than Barack Obama was leading her in 2008. So it should be a good day for Hillary
Clinton. Yeah, it's a big day. We shall see. And Boris, when it comes to the general election, do you think that Donald Trump can sustain the kind of energy that we've been seeing?
100%. If you look at the numbers, in 2008, the Democrats had 3 billion people more turn out for them than Republicans. On Super Tuesday in 2016, Republicans had 3 million more people turn out. So there's been a huge swing from enthusiasm for Democrats to enthusiasm for Republicans, and that's been all behind Donald Trump. If you look at states like Michigan, Ohio, and Pennsylvania, Donald Trump has much more of a shot than any other candidate has really since Ronald Reagan, as far as the GOP is concerned. So I do respectfully disagree with Bakari, and I think while Hillary Clinton may be welcoming a matchup with Donald Trump, I think that's a mistake. And it's a mistake that a lot of the GOP made as well. He was taken very lightly when he entered this race, and now he's the presumptive nominee. So I think for Hillary, who has a huge problem with trustworthiness, to look at and say, hey, I'm going to be beating Donald Trump handily, is a huge mistake, and she will be underestimating him just like she did to Barack Obama in 08. Lastly, if we do look at 2000, we as Republicans will be totally fine if the result is exactly the same, and we have the next president be a Republican.
Boris, let's talk about today. What if, it's a big what if, because the polls show that he is ahead in Florida right now, but what if Trump loses Ohio and Florida today? Will he be able to get enough votes to secure the nomination? A lot of people saying no.
Susan, he's up by 20% in most polls in Florida, so I think that's a pretty big stretch. Mm-hmm. If he does not win both those states, he can absolutely still get that majority, because you have a lot of big states coming up, you know, in the future. You've got even Utah next Tuesday, and then you've got New York, California, and on and on. But I'm very confident that he's going to win Florida. Ohio's going to be close, but he's also going to win Missouri, North Carolina, and Illinois. He's doing very well in polling in all those states. It's going to be another good Tuesday for Donald Trump.
And we'll see if any candidates drop out after the results of today. Bakari Sellers, Boris Epstein, thank you so much.
Thanks so much.
And we're going to talk more politics. Donald Trump and CNN political commentator Tara Setmayer. She is not supporting Trump. I want to point that out. And good to have you both on. And Tara, I'll start with you. There is a real possibility that Ohio is the only state that Trump does not win today. If that is the case, is the Republican Party establishment, do you think, going to back him? Or could they start backing Governor Kasich? Is Ohio enough for Governor Kasich?
Well, I think that obviously what we've seen lately is that the Republican establishment is trying to figure out how we have a contested convention or stop Donald Trump from getting these delegates because of you know, a number of reasons that are problematic with his candidacy. And so it depends on how things shake out today. If he wins both Florida and Ohio, I think it becomes exponentially more difficult for that argument to be made, per se. But then again, on the other side, they need to do a really good job of explaining that contested conventions are actually quite normal. They've happened many times. It's just that it hasn't happened since 1976 on our side. So folks are thinking that this is somehow taking away votes from Donald Trump. But if he doesn't win the 1237, he doesn't have the majority, then we're not taking votes away. That means that the conventions are set for someone to win the majority of delegates. And if he doesn't win those majority of delegates going into Cleveland, then that's what the conventions are ultimately for. So I think it depends on what happens. If he loses Ohio
and
but
Florida.
He wins other places, they're proportional. Only Ohio and Florida are winner take all. And Ted Cruz could actually pull out some delegates here, surprisingly, not necessarily winning those states. So it's complicated. We'll see tomorrow.
An easier
answer for that.
John Kasich, I do want to play this sound for both of you. This is what John Kasich said right after he voted this morning.
I've been very concerned. I just saw a commercial, I guess it was last night, of these comments that were made about women. I have two daughters. They see this stuff. What do you think they think?
Here is the ad he's talking about, and then we'll talk about it.
You know, it really doesn't matter what they write, as long as you've got a young and beautiful piece of ass.
That must be a pretty picture. You drop into your knees.
There was blood coming out of her eyes. Blood coming out of her wherever.
Say what you will about Donald Trump, but that ad certainly worked. It got you to stop and watch hearing what he said out of the mouths of women. Boris, any concern this ad could do any damage to Trump's campaign? Or does it just reiterate the people who don't like Trump are going to not like him even more?
Donald Trump's had hundreds of millions of dollars of super PAC money, donor money, whatever you call the establishment, that amorphous thing we call the establishment money, pointed at him, and it has not stopped him in states all across America. The ad is well put together, but I do not think that it's going to have any impact. And we'll see at the end of today, he's going to win Florida, Illinois, North Carolina. He's going to be very competitive in Ohio, where you have a governor, Kasich, who won 86 out of 88 counties in Ohio. He's that popular, and he's either tied or up by a few points over Donald Trump. So you're seeing somebody who is completely unstoppable so far in Donald Trump. And as far as Governor Kasich goes, I guess we've seen the end of the warm and fuzzy candidate. Now he is turning into the attack. Rubio tried the same thing. He tried to out-Trump Trump.
Well, Kasich really wasn't attacking. He's just saying, look, I have two daughters. His ad is pretty horrible.
Listen, he's saying what Donald Trump reportedly said is horrible, right? He was agreeing with the ad. So he's definitely turning his sights onto Donald Trump. And he said he was going to do so now. He had Mitt Romney with him, Mitt Romney, who I support in 2012 and greatly respect, but who I think made a mistake in coming after Donald Trump as hard as he did. These kind of moments, the kind of moments of the quote-unquote establishment going after Donald Trump, only help Donald Trump, because the voters are tired of politics the same old way, and they're turning to somebody who's new and who wasn't a politician up to 8 months ago.
And Tara, what was your response to that ad? Have you watched it?
Oh, yeah. I saw it yesterday, and I promptly tweeted it out because people need to see this. Mm-hmm. This is a preview of what the general election attacks would be, just one of many, against Donald Trump if he is, God forbid, our nominee. So Trump's own words coming out of women. And then at the end of that ad, it's about a minute long, you hear these women say, these are your mothers, your daughters, your sisters, being spoken about this way by a potential presidential candidate. That is very powerful. The problem here is that it's too late. All of those quotes were in existence 6 months ago. Why didn't they have those kinds of attack ads against him months ago so that women could see what Donald Trump has said, his behavior, his past behaviors? See, he hasn't really been vetted until about the last three weeks. He's been given a pass.
The rift with Megyn Kelly was very well publicized, so that comment was out there for a long time.
But that rift was framed as she's the establishment and part of the Fox News conspiracy against Trump.
Guys, I do want to get to this question. It is important. Senator Bernie Sanders' wife, Jane, toured the infamous Tent City Jail ran by Maricopa County, Arizona Sheriff Joe Arpaio. And for years, activists have alleged human rights violations in Tent City. Well, according to Jane, she questioned the sheriff over the operation of the facility, but didn't get any answers. So, Bora, Sheriff Arpaio endorses your candidate. What do you make out of Jane Sanders making this tour of the prison?
Listen, it's a good political stunt for the Democrats, right? I'm sure they'll go after it pretty well, and the Democrats are going to buy into it. The Democrats are showing no enthusiasm for their leader, Hillary Clinton. So Ms. Sanders is doing the right thing from her perspective, from winning the Democrat primary. It's not going to matter in the general. Now, we are talking about Hillary as the presumptive nominee, but if this day turns out as good for Sanders as the last few Tuesdays have, the Democrats are going to have as much, if not more, of a contested convention than we may, because we are looking at Donald Trump being the nominee, and it's much less sure on the Democrat side.
Today is a big deciding factor. Boris Epstein and Tara Setmeyer, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We could talk about that ad for a very